We start in the lobby, where you create and manage your projects in SAP Build. In the current release, Joule Studio enables you to create Joule skills. These are deterministic and task-specific in nature. When designing a Joule skill, you must give a careful consideration to the description, because this will be used by Joule to choose from it from all the other capabilities it has available. In this demonstration, we have a scenario where an ID badge should be created in a third-party system after a preliminary check in an SAP system. Joule needs to know what user input to expect and what it should ask for if necessary. Joule skills can also be a building block for other Joule skills, and in the future, also tools that agents can use. So it can make sense to specify output parameters. Now we add the first action, which is a call to an API to retrieve employee data. At design time, we need a destination variable. When the project is deployed, the actual destination to use will be specified. From the skill inputs, we map the employee ID to the business partner input of the action. Similarly, we add the second action, which is a call to the badge system. This time, when we open the skill content to do the data mapping, we have the result of the first action as well as the skill inputs available. Let us quickly check what the output looks like. We could let Joule generate its response to the user, but in this case, we will specify the response with a send message. In this scenario, we give the user the opportunity to navigate to the badge system to check the result of the Joule skill. To finish the design, let us map the output so that the skill could be usefully incorporated into other scenarios. Now that the design is complete, we just need to release and deploy the project. Here we specify the actual destinations to the systems. Now we can test our new Joule skill in the Joule Digital Assistant. Here, I asked Joule to create a badge for the employee. The Joule skill has been successfully executed.